For a child is born unto us, and a son is given unto us. He will be called a wonderful counselor, the Prince of Peace, the Almighty God, the Everlasting Father. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. I welcome you to another episode of Come Let's Discuss the Bible. My guests, as usual, they are here with me. From the first right, I have my daddy in the Lord, Pastor Matthew Orimoloye. God bless you, daddy.
Thank you, sir.
And welcome to our program, sir. From my left is my mommy in the Lord, Pastor Mrs. Fumi Aloko. Mommy, you're welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you, ma'am. Today, by the special grace of God, we want to talk about Christmas. I know many of us, we always celebrate Christmas. Christmas is coming now, everybody is full of joy, preparing, buying clothes, food. They are just ready for merriment. And many does not know the reason why we are celebrating Christmas. They don't even know the meaning of it. So we are going to tell you more about it. Let me start from my mommy. What is the reason for Christmas?
Jesus is the reason for Christmas. You know, Christmas, the root word there is Christ. And so you can't be talking about Christmas without the word Christ. So Jesus is the reason for the season. As much as Christmas is one of the festivals that is celebrated by all.
Hallelujah. Jesus is the reason for Christmas. Praise the Lord. Daddy, do you have any different word from you, sir?
I don't have any contrary opinion. As was rightly said, Christmas is the word Christ, and Jesus Christ is the main reason for the celebration, for the season. So, Jesus Christ is the one we are celebrating. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Jesus is the one that we are celebrating. And we shall continue to celebrate Jesus forever in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Then when we are talking about Christmas, who are the people that needed to celebrate Christ? Daddy?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If we look into the scripture, by the announcement of the birth of Jesus Christ by angel and Gabriel, in Luke chapter 1, the Bible made us to understand that the Son will be given back to him, and he is for a purpose. For the whole world, for the salvation of mankind. And the purpose of Christ coming to the world is to save us. In John chapter 3, verse 16, say, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life.
Hallelujah.
So the purpose of his birth is for everybody, for God so loved the entire world. And that's why he gave Christ for the entire world.
Hallelujah. Mommy?
Yes, that is very correct. Christ has come to die for all. And so everybody can celebrate Christmas. But if you really want to celebrate Christmas with understanding, then you must have a relationship with him. That is when we'll be celebrating Christmas with understanding.
We must have understanding of him. We must have good relationship with our Savior for you to understand why we are celebrating the Christmas. And also, we are saying, you said that Christmas is made for everybody. So one will not say, I don't know, I'm not part of them, so why should I be celebrating Christmas?
In fact, when you look at the season Christmas falls to, incidentally, it is towards the end of the year.
Yes.
And naturally, everyone is like, thank God I made it December 25.
Hallelujah.
So there's this joy around that even the Muslims, you see them also going about, you know, saying, Akwodu, you know, everyone is saying Akwodu. Perhaps because of this period, the timing for Christmas.
Hallelujah. It is made for everybody. God bless us in Jesus' name. Then how do we celebrate Christmas? Is there any special method or special way that we need to celebrate Christmas, Mom?
Well, anything that we will do, when we do it, we must be careful to be sinless. You make sure it is void of sin. So if you are a child of God and you are celebrating Christmas, you are celebrating the Lord Jesus. It is an opportunity to remember the birth of Jesus Christ. And for humanity, for humankind, that is the best thing that has happened to us. And so if you are a child of God, if you know Jesus, you have a relationship with you, I congratulate you. Then you will be able to celebrate Christmas meaningfully with the joy of heaven in you, the joy of salvation.
Daddy, praise the Lord, hallelujah.
To stand from where mommy is taught, you know, even in the body of Christ, many of us take the celebration of Christmas for eating of rice or whatever, chicken and the rest of them. There are lessons we need to learn. Number one, the Bible says a son is given unto us, on whose shoulder rest shall rest the kingdom of God. And he is a prince of peace, the everlasting Father. So we should not lose sight of the purpose of his birth. In Isaiah chapter 6, verse 9, verse 6. So that verse tells us categorically the purpose of his birth, what he is coming to the world to do. So coming, when you're talking about celebrating Christmas, number one, is reminding us of the purpose of his coming to the world. Then number two, we also need to know that he came, he died, he was buried, and on the third day rose up, and is seated on the right hand of God forever. And then waiting expectantly for as many that believe in his name, you know, to walk within the confines of God's will. So in other words, it's a period to remind us that one day Christ Jesus will come. One day, don't forget the prophecy about his birth was given and it came to pass. And then the prophecy about the second coming is also given. And definitely it's going to come to pass. So when it comes, are we going to say, well, it's because of celebration? Like Madame said the other time, when we're celebrating Christmas, we should not celebrate him with sin along with it. So in other words, she's telling us that we should not lose sight of the importance of the birth of Christ. And I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. What are the joy that Christmas brings? Mommy?
Yes, the joy Christmas brings. You know, like I do say if all we want to do is just live on earth and also think that this is where we will end it, that, like the Bible says, we are most miserable. The joy Christmas brings is the consciousness of heaven, like Daddy said, that Jesus is coming back to take his own away. Basically, for me, the joy Christmas brings is the joy of salvation, the joy of heaven. That's it.
Praise the Lord. Amen. The joy of salvation, the joy of heaven. Let me ask you a question, Daddy. Did the joy of Christmas prepare one for heaven?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes and no. It now depends on the motive of individual. In the sense that you know that this is a period where we remember the birth of Christ Jesus. And if at the time you are the one that is genuinely born again, we know that it is not the meat and the whatever you are going to eat or the drinks you will drink that matters to you. But what matters to you is that one day Jesus Christ will come, as it is clearly stated in the scriptures. And don't let me just digress a little bit. Do you know, sir, Quran also believes that Jesus is coming back? But many people will not know that one, because there's a portion in the book of in Quran that talks about his birth. In fact, Quran refers to Jesus as a spirit from God. But unfortunately, many of them are trying to cover it up. And so, in other words, they talk about his birth, his resurrection. So if as a child of God, you know that the purpose of this Christmas is not just for merrymaking. It is to remind me that one day the trumpet will sound. Of course, that person, that group of people are preparing, you know, they're conscious of heaven, like Madame Lulu said. Then second, the other group, why I said no, is because many people don't even know why they are celebrating Christmas. Many believe that, yes, it's a period of enjoyment, it's a period of refreshment, it's a period you have to visit friends and, you know, do a sort of parties, drink and wine. So if the the major thing is lost on the ground of the drinking and wine. That means the person does not have heaven in view. And so the idea of making the kingdom of God is no longer in the dictionary of such a person.
Such a person.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Mommy.
Daddy has said it all. If you are a Christian, it is yes. If you are not, it is no. Because you will not celebrate Christmas with understanding.
Christmas. Let me back in of the Bible over Christmas.
You know, this is it is a topic that has attracted a lot of so many controversies. Actually, when the Bible talks about the birth of Christ Jesus, number one, the Bible does not say this is the birth day of Jesus, begin to remember it in my remembrance. Mm-hmm. For ministry, I have a book at home with me. For ministry, the word Christmas, the word Easter, everything according to that book is tied to Babylonish aquatic origin.
Yeah.
And where on the 25th day, which is the day they worship their goddess of Mars or whatever they call it, but I forgot the name of that, but I'm legalized and took of Christmas to be celebrated on that day. But whether it is for the idol on that day, or whether it is not for the idol on that day, what is essential for you and for me is that at least Paul said, people preach Christ, whether in love or on the other side. One thing that gladdens our heart is that Christ is being preached.
Mm.
So what is important is not whether there is a biblical backup for Christmas, or what we need to understand is that for God putting it to the mind of that emperor, that I can't remember if it is in Constantinople, that legalized it. But definitely, whether right or wrong, whether pure motive or not pure motive, one thing that we need to look at and be glad at is that Christ is being remembered. So even the Gentiles or even the occulty people, as people believe it to be, are also helping us to remember who we believe in. So we Christians should not begin to argue whether there is a biblical backup, whether it is idolatry day or not idolatry day. But one thing that we need to be conscious of is that Jesus Christ is being proclaimed. And praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, the word Christmas is not in the Bible, but like we identified, the root word Christ is in the Bible. And if it's the reason for the season, that settles it. Argument or no argument, the way Daddy said it, it is an opportunity to still establish the personality of Jesus in the heart of everyone. Either you take it or you leave it. That date, December 25, is set aside for Christmas. It's known all over the world. Though it is not celebrated all over, maybe in the Arab countries, they may not celebrate Christmas. If you're a Christian there, you may just do your own in your corner.
Mm.
But maybe the nation is not taking it. But they still know that today, some people somewhere is doing this for so person.
Mm. Mm.
So I think it's a welcome idea. That we have Christmas.
I need to add to what Mommy said is that the Bible says the gospel shall be preached to all over the world. So, and I believe it's another means of taking Christ even to the new creation of the whole world, even though the world might not accept that which we are talking about.
Mm.
But for the mere fact that the name is being mentioned and is being remembered, is a testimony against us.
Praise the Lord.
Then, before we. Is there a way that we Christians, or is there a way that Christians can celebrate this Christmas by bringing other people to Christ? Is there any way?
Yes, individually we can take on evangelism. And we can also use Christmas as an opportunity to give. And when you are doing your giving, in the course of the giving, you also preach Christ, because the Jesus coming into the world is an act of giving. God gave his only begotten Son. And I think we have a church, the Redeemed Christian Church of God. They are known for evangelism during that season. There is a program the Redeemed Christian Church of God holds every Christmas. It is called go and fishing. It's an opportunity to go all out and win souls unto the kingdom.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Daddy? I think in addition to what Mori said, we can also organize programs like teaching emergency, hospital emergency, whereby we give out things to those people who need Christmas period to make them feel that, yes, they are part and parcel of society. They use the opportunity to minister Christ to them.
It's an avenue, as we have said, to witness Christ to people that are yet to know Jesus and bring them in. Also, I want to thank you for coming for this program today. I pray that the spirit of Christmas, the joy in Christmas, will prepare us for the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Till we meet next time, from me, BC Arokosui, I say thank you.